Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for coming this evening. I've been directing the Impulse Percussion Group for 16 years, and I have to tell you, it never gets old. I was lucky that in 2010, I worked with a composer-designer named Mary Ellen Childs and learned how the elements used in theater and opera could actually be applied to large chamber ensembles. Thank you very much for the mic. Like IPG. And that also even more so when I got a chance to work with Nick Johnson on a piece we did together called Feast. He was so generous to let me participate and my students to work with them, from an improvisation piece on pandero to flamenco clapping to finally the use of a gentleman named Tom McGuire, who created these percussion arches. They were electronic, and the dancers would actually step on a pedal that would start them. And I had three students. We kind of worked out and meshed out all the music that we were going to play. I kind of wrote a bunch of things down, and they improvised with the dancers. And I will tell you, it was just an incredible experience. And having people like that to influence me has made it a pleasure to do all the concerts we do here. And by the way, Nick Johnson is in the audience, so please give him a round of applause. However, all this lighting and things like this has to be done by the professionals, and we are so lucky to have a lot of students who are really interested in working behind the scenes to make this all happen. So without them, we weren't able to create that kind of visual element that accompanies the music that we're doing tonight. The piece you just heard is by Dave Hall. He recently joined the faculty of North Texas University in Denton. And even though this is a recent piece, and that we have titled this concert Classics Rock, Dave Hall's music is so well crafted and pleasing that I am sure that very soon he will become part of the pantheon of the Hall of Fame in percussion. The other two pieces on this first half are Ionization by Edgar Varese and Gainsborough by Tom Geiger. Ionization is the third piece in our program, so that was the first, and was written in the early 1930s, and it's an abstract idea of ionization. The process ionization regarding atoms could be much better explained by my dear friend David Eichhorn, who is here, but I think it would be as interesting as me talking to you about snare drum articulations like the four-stroke ruff. Really interesting stuff. Okay, that joke went badly. All right, no problem. I've got more. That said, we see ionization all the time. We see it in lightning, the aurora borealis, even in electric shock from static electricity. Varese used this knowledge at the time in the 30s to try to create and put an idea of this into musical notation. When you listen to this piece, you'll hear all kinds of drums, but also gongs, sirens, metal pipes, as well as very complex rhythms. Ionization was the first work ever written for large chamber percussion. And in the opening words from the review from its premiere at Carnegie Hall in 1933, the reviewer wrote, "A wonderful and terrifying composition. Contains almost nothing of the traditional tone quality. Scored for a Gatling gun species of percussion instruments, this new work is a complete singular piece of music." This is the first time that I have really integrated rock with the IPG. When I was in high school, one of my favorite bands was Emerson, Lake & Palmer. Besides the tunes Carnival 9, "Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends." You've probably all heard that tune before. His version, or their version, of Copland's Fanfare for the Common Man were really exciting to me. And then, of course, was the Nutcracker that they did. And being from Boston, Boston Bruins used that as their opening theme song. So I grew up with that as a kid. And learning the notes to a 5/4 time piece like Tarkus was absolutely mind-blowing at age 15. So when I heard that a group from Italy, a gentleman named Massimo Pastore, had written the whole first side of the album of Tarkus out for a percussion group, for the 50th anniversary, which is just 2 years ago, I knew we had to give it a shot. So this piece is seven movements, but it is basically 20 minutes of nonstop playing with a few small breaks. So unless you are a cult follower, you may not know the in particular tunes. You might have heard especially the first one if you were of my age or older. So I'm sure there are a few of you. As for the other pieces, Abbey Road, which will be on the second half by Brad Sturz, he made a great arrangement of what is my first favorite band, the Beatles. And there's, of course, more to come, which we'll talk about with the other pieces on the second half and some of my very good friends that are accompanying us tonight. So thank you very much for being here. Enjoy our next piece, Gainsborough, by Thomas Geiger. Thank you. hope you've enjoyed so far. We've had a great time performing for you. Thank you. For those of you who have been attending for the past few years or have been watching online, you might know that I made a pledge to promote past alumni to perform here with the IPG. Tonight continues that pledge with two of my former grad students and now close friends, Andrew Slater, who is a Wichita Symphony member, professor of percussion at Friends University. He also works with me in, with the Tulsa Symphony. And also, a member of the Daydream Band here in Wichita. If you've never seen them, you should go out and see them. They are an amazing band. They did the whole first side or the whole album of Pink Floyd. I think which one it is. I can't remember. But they are amazing. Sorry about that for my little. Let's see, Luc Brust, who actually was playing bass marimba on Tarkus with us today. He's also going to be playing again. And Luke recently just moved back from Las Vegas here to Wichita. And he also has been playing with the Wichita Symphony. He plays with the Grand Opera here in Wichita. And also is a percussionist for many of the shows that are at the Crown Uptown. Having them as colleagues and friends, performing with them again on the IPG stage as professionals is not only gratifying for me, but it's a huge thing for my students who see them and see their own future through them. I am overjoyed, over the moon to have Dr. James Pisano here with us. Luckily, he was free to perform. Jim is somewhat recent to the School of Music faculty, but his contribution to our growth here at WSU School of Music and the stature that we're attaining is quite immeasurable. Jim will be performing on the next two pieces, and as you will see, his playing is not just amazing technically, he is incredibly lyrical, funky, virtuosic, but most of all, he is infectious when he plays. When you hear him play the last piece, Asia, not only does he play the famous and incredibly difficult solo that was played on the album by Wayne Shorter, he sounds like Wayne Shorter. Working with Jim, or even better, when I get the chance to play with him, reminds me why I love music. The arrangement for I Wish is by Dan Chisholm. Again, a wonderful colleague and a WSU alum of the percussion studio here. And Dan, you are the class of, because he's here in the audience. 84. Hey, me too. How about that? Just not of WSU. And I asked Dan to arrange this, both this Stevie Wonder piece regarding the original recording, as well as a version that I heard from the former first violinist of the Turtle Island String Quartet, a guy named Tracy Silverman, who played this as a one-man band with his electric violin. And Luc Brust, who I was talking about before, is going to be our lead vibraphone player, playing a solo as well with Jim, and as well as Jared Hearn, my GTA, who's gonna be playing drums on that. Asia, okay. So, huge shout out for Olin, the guy who did this arrangement. I heard it a long time ago when he was a grad student at UMass Amherst, and if you are a drummer, life pretty much begins and ends with Steve Gadd's version of Asia. Steve Gadd is one of the most legendary drummers of all time. So sitting in for the great Steve Gadd tonight is my dear friend, Andrew Slater. So before I go, I wanted to thank a few people who have come through to play for us, to work with us, to advise my students, adjudicate and uplift them over this semester. Miguel Santana Morales. Miguel is a GTA here. For jazz, and he did this incredible percussion of Puerto Rico Latin workshop with my students. Matt Wilson was just here, class of 86. Matt is one of the most well-known drummers in the world today, lives in Long Island, known him for now a good long time, and he was here playing with the Jazz Festival with Bobby Watson and took time out of his day, 2.5 hours to spend with my students, listening to them play some of this stuff tonight and uplifting them. Joe Gramley was just here, thanks to Lynn Davis, our professor of organ, who brought him here with his organ and percussion duo. He's at Indiana University. He's also well known for having been the percussionist with the Yo-Yo Ma group called, sorry, it's slipping my mind too. Someone shouted out. Thank you, Silk Road Ensemble. There you go. Great. Yeah, and Joe's just an incredible performer, and it was really uplifting for my students to see him. And now, locally from was once LA here before, Joe Peck is now here in back in town. Joe is an incredible steel pan player, and he's been bringing that love to my students. One of the best things about being here at WSU is that there's so many great talents within the school itself that we get to hear, as well as those who went to school here and also our invited guests who perform here. Speaking of great talents here at WSU, my colleagues Will Flynn, professor of guitar, and Mark Foley, professor of bass, got two of their exceptional students to perform with us tonight. Olivia Massey and on bass and Andrew Highbarger on guitar. These are two people who are on a trajectory for success. There is nothing better than having students from other studios come and perform with your studio, perform with the IPG, and even better, when they come to their first rehearsal, really professional, all notes learned, completely prepared to play. I am incredibly grateful for them, and I am glad that they have joined the IPG family. Lastly, I wanted to acknowledge two of my wonderful students, Helena Kopp and Evan Boyd, who are graduating this semester. They have been an invaluable asset to the studio. They have influenced me while they've been here, and certainly changed my life since they've been here. I've really enjoyed working with them. So that's it. Thank you for being here. Enjoy the rest of the show.
Thank you.